I am a powerful woman.
Amen.
Both in Christ and in body.
Amen.
And in strength.
Amen.
I will climb on the chair to reach my son height.
Amen.
And when I tell him, kneel down so I can reach him, better kneel down because I will make him come down.
Amen.
Yes.
Yes.
So, don't have excuses to say, I am a woman. The father gone. No. Be assertive.
Yes.
Stand for what you mean.
Amen.
Do not say yes. And by the time or no. And by the time the child look on you two times and give you the bad eye, they say, alright, baby, come, it's alright. They look for me, but alright, that's your attitude. Go. No. 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 You're not setting any example.
Yes. Yes.
Last week I tell you that you lead by example.
Amen.
And you have to lead by example. You can't leave your children again to take care of them oneself.
Amen.
You're not molding them.
Come on.
You're not molding them right at all.
Amen.
You got to be the parents for them.
Yes.
Even when they're bad.
Yeah.
Even when they're despicable, because some of these children are very despicable.
Yes.
I remember one time I was driving in my car and Shaq was, at the time I'm telling you that boy was so sharp, I don't know what happened to him now. He was only 6 or so, and he said, look at me, I'm driving and he's at the back in his seat. And he looked and he said, oh my God, that boy looked despicable. I was shocked to know that this boy knew this meaning of this word, despicable. I said, what? I know the word despicable, so I said, what is despicable? He said, Mom, look over there, his pants is all the way down here. I said, Shaquille, as of this day, you better remember, you told me that that boy looked despicable because his pants is all the way down here. Because the day I see you with your pants down there is the day judgment will come.
Amen.
Because you must not wear your pants down here. You hear how much you tell me it's despicable?
Come on.
My child wears pants at his waist.
Yes.
If he wears it past his waist, Sharon won't see it.
Mm-hmm.
Because if Sharon sees it, have to pull up.
Yes.
These are, you know, these young people I'm following again. I'm going to tell you this. You might not know. When you wear your pants down there, you're inviting male to say you're available for sex. You are available for mating with them. You are one of them. That's what it means. Do not wear your pants down here. It's not cute. It don't look good.
Amen.
When you're going outside, pull up your pants.
Right.
Dress like a man.
Right.
And have your chest down, but that's what it means.
Yes.
That is what it means. Right. There's no pretty way about it.
Right.
You are inviting men to yourself.
Amen.
You are telling them that you are available for their immorality.
Mm-hmm.
You are telling them that you're a part of their world.
Jesus.
That is what it means. You look it up. That is what it means. You do research and you will know. That is what it means.
Yes.
When you go to Jamaica, it's all over the place. Then them type it up, put it up and tell you. That is what it means also.
Amen.
So young men, wear your pants at your waist.
Yes.
Amen.
And especially your children of God.
Yes.
You can't wear your pants like that.
Amen.
If you are children of God, you should pull your pants up. Like how them said, ladies must be covered.
Yes.
You understand? When you go into the house of the Lord, covered. And you're on the road, covered because
yes.
of God, child of God.
Amen.
Don't expose yourself to anything because you're available.
Yes.
Or look at me. It's not cute, it's not look good.
Come on. Yeah. Come on.
Amen.
Amen.
I don't want to ask you for an amen. I need to hear it.
Amen.
I need to hear, praise the Lord. No excuse now. When you go in the presence of the Lord and the Lord said, so why were you wearing your pants like that?
Exactly.
Why were you unheard swagging? Because they call it swag.
Yes.
You want a good swagger? dress proper.
Right.
Young man, young women,
yes.
Dress appropriate, not inappropriate.
Come on.
Dress properly.
Yes.
Where is your morals?
Mm-hmm.
You need to have it. I stress on that morals, and I come back with it this week. You need to have morals.
Yes.
Integrity.
Yes.
Stand upright for
yes.
God.
Yes, come on.
When you're showing up, you know the other day, I went to the store and I woke up Sister John. And Minister Sterling. And we were in line. And a lady cut in front of us.
Go ahead.
And when she realized that she cut in front of us, she panicked a bit.
Mm-hmm.
Said, it's okay, honey. Go ahead. We are not in a hurry. And she stayed there for a little bit. Then she said, I'm not a Christian.
Mm-hmm.
I said, Christianity is a religion, sister. We are follower of Christ, and Sister Sterling said, we are children of Christ.
Amen.
Because this, if I'm telling you something, if you're born into a Muslim family, you become a Muslim. You're a Muslim because
yes,
you're
yes,
born into a Muslim
yes,
family.
Right.
It's a religion.
Yes.
So if you're born in a Buddha, is it Buddhist?
Mm-hmm.
That means you're a Buddha. You're studying Buddha, is it?
Yes.
When your parents is a born in a Christian home, it doesn't mean that they, because they, your parents baptized, that's the religion, that's what they study. They study the law of God,
mm-hmm.
Almighty God, Jehovah God. That means you're...
Before God came to the earth to say, man, what did he give? He gave a gift.
Yes.
For God so loved, how can we demonstrate our love? It's through a gift. Don't tell me you love me when you never give me a gift. I mean a gift of pride. I mean a gift of love. I mean a gift of hug. A gift of a nice, consoling word.